to get it on camera. Do you believe?
I believe it was a man in a monkey suit.
There's no such thing as Bigfoot. There's no such thing as zombies. But that was no man in a monkey suit.
Get your hopes up. Allow me to empty my cup. I am not a superhero. I am not a superstar. I'm the guy you ask to help you move. I'm the guy you meet at your local bar. And I am no Boy Scout all dressed up for show and go. Oh no. In my little head, my grandma's warning echoes from long ago. Michael, remember, you reap what you sow.
Mr. Thornton, I'm leaving now. I have tickets to the theater. Michael.
Go ahead. Have a good night.
And Michael, I realize this may not be convenient, but I'd like to ask for a raise. Before you say anything, I'm very proficient with my duties, and the clients like me very much.
Little people.
You mean like, what, children?
Yes, children. And I'm told dogs like me very much. You don't see me asking for a raise.
I hear in Europe you get a raise the very first day you start a job.
Now why doesn't that surprise me? What kind of raise are we talking?
I don't know. Nothing grand or obnoxious, just something that says you appreciate me and my efforts and my many, many talents.
Can't I just say I do appreciate you and be done with it?
No, it doesn't work that way, Michael. You should know that. Besides, I thought you said you were in a good mood today.
Good moods. Yeah, I am in a good mood. Go ahead. Give yourself a raise. I'll sign it on Monday morning.
Well, and now you can count me among the many dogs and children that like you. And our dear, dear mother will be very pleased with your generosity.
Enjoy your show, sis.
Have a pleasant weekend, Mr. Thornton.
You haven't heard about the sighting?
Go on.
It seems Bigfoot is back.
You don't say.
I do say. It seems Sasquatch is alive and well. Multiple sightings in the last 3 days, although some say it looked like an escaped ape or a gorilla.
Is that a different one?
Ah, beat me.
But one man says his two dogs are missing.
And he thinks Bigfoot did it?
What kind of dog?
Large ones, German shepherds.
They were outside barking up a storm last night, y'all. Then one of them, yes, he went outside. No dogs lying. Not even a trace of the dog.
Jawohl, it's been a very long winter. Perhaps he ate his dog.
Oh, hey, if you see two large German shepherd dogs two-stepping up through the woods, give us a call. But if you see Bigfoot...
Oh, run!
And now back to some summer music.
Hello.
Hi, welcome to my home.
Oh, this is quite lovely.
Where would you like to conduct the interview? I thought maybe the living room would be more.
Oh, this is just delightful. What if we have her seated in front of the fireplace?
Hello, this is Phil Philbin, and I have the remarkable opportunity of being in the lovely home of famed author Lee Wee. Ms. Wee has agreed to tell us her extraordinary happenstance on camera in this exclusive interview.
Lee, could you tell us your experience exactly as it unfolded?
We were on our usual Thursday afternoon hike, and in no time, we were very much alone in the wilderness. There was a low growl from the growth in front of me, and I know it was not from a small animal, and I was frozen in my spot. And then it appeared. I came to the ravine, and I didn't know where to go. I was free falling, just 50 feet straight down, and I don't know if I jumped or the creature shoved me, but I blacked out, and when I came to, I was in a creek, and the smell was gone, so I surmised that the creature had also vanished.
Now, is this when this happened? What's up, Jerry?
Are you at the cabin?
I am.
Is she on her way?
She is.
Are you still going through with it? Look, Jerry.
After Jessica died, I thought about her every single day. And I'll be the first to admit my second marriage was a huge mistake. But Sarah's different. I think I'm very much in love.
And you're not too proud to admit it.
Third time's a charm, huh?
You said it.
Do you have a ring?
Of course.
I'll pop the question tonight.
She'll say yes.
Are you on your way to another happy hour at Rick's bar?
No, I'm on the way to the cabin.
Your cabin. I've got some docs you have to sign off on. They have to be delivered tomorrow morning. It's very, very important to us. I thought we were fine. After last week.
Bad news, good news.
They started seizing our assets, but stopped abruptly. I moved all that I could without raising a red flag to the IRS
to come and arrest us.
How bad is it?
You mean how bad was it?
On a scale of 1 to 10, it was a 10 plus. We're lucky the Russians didn't bury us at the bottom of the state.
Sorry. Not bad.
Look, with a little maneuvering, some timing, we'll survive this and be better than ever. That's good to hear.
I don't know how you managed it.
You must be the luckiest guy I know. Russians usually don't give up. Cut off the head. What's that?
Bye.
Yeah.
Well, I hate to ask, but are they still looking for him?
No. They think he doesn't want to be found.
Ooh, and we certainly don't want him to be found.
Not on the phone, Jerry.
Well, how's Sarah doing?
She thinks he's gone into hiding.
Oh, that's good.
That's good, too. Time heals all wounds. When will you be here?
Well, traffic's a bitch. Probably 2 or 3 hours.
To Sarah? Within the hour.
Well, say hello for me until I can say it myself.
I'll do that.
Oh, and Mike. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you. I'm here.
Hey, I just wanted to let you know I'm going to be a little late. Traffic sucks.
So I've heard.
I can't wait to see you. Are you okay?
If I lost everything.
I'd love you even more.
Hey, what's happening?
Nothing to worry about. Jerry says we have it under control.
I just want you to know that no matter what, I will always love you. Doesn't matter what happens. I'll see you soon, Michael.
See you soon.
You are one of the world's authorities on these creatures?
Well, I am the world's foremost authority on the cryptic hominid, or Gigantopithecus canadensis. Or in lay terms, the Sasquatch, and its more guttural cousin, Bigfoot. And we must also include the Yeti in any discussions of scientific merit. And I am slightly taken aback at the robust, renewed interest in these wonderful creatures.
Lovely, lovely. And you say you can imitate their sounds?
Oh, sounds. Oh, of course. And if I may say so, I'm an expert in all three.
Oh. Could you give us an actual demonstration if needed?
Demonstration? Oh, I'm very flattered that you've asked. I will first do the Yeti. Oh! And now, the Sasquatch. And now the piece de resistance, the Bigfoot.
Have you ever actually seen one of these creatures?
Oh, alas, no. Never. But I do believe with my whole heart that I will one day walk hand in hand with them in my next lifetime.
I'm sure the feeling is mutual.
I'm just saying, any animal that is teased long enough will attack you. What about a shark? Sharks go attack you whether you tease it or not. I'm not talking about a shark, I'm talking about a land animal.
Is a shark considered to be an animal? I know it's a fish, but is it an animal?
I think so.
Yeah, I think so too.
So what's the difference between a Yeti, a Sasquatch, and Bigfoot?
Alright, so a Yeti is like the abominable snowman. He's all white and he lives in the snow.
Agreed.
A Sasquatch makes his home in the redwoods.
Also agreed.
But Bigfoot?
Bigfoot can live anywhere.
Give the lady a prize.
Why are we here again?
$200 a pound morel mushrooms.
Where are these fun guys?
They're the funnest.
It should be just over this way.
Oh my god. What is that?
Stalker. I just see you in this coffee shop all the time, and I wanted to say hi. I'm Sarah.
To you, whenever you arrive.
Michael?
Cheers. Well, it's about time. What happened? Where's your accent?
My father insisted that I go through only the best schools.
Step, isn't it?
You're scared, it's a big step. You're a big, strong man. I think you can handle it. Are you a big, strong man, Mike?
I have my thoughts.
Thank you.
Gotten the water, we'd have no problems right now.
No problems? You don't even know where we are. Who doesn't bring a map or a cell phone?
Why would I want some kind of electronic device out here, amongst all this natural beauty? It's the antithesis of why we came out here.
And I'm just realizing how truly clueless you really are. First rule of hiking, know where you are at all times.
Well, where's your cell phone?
In the car, which we can't find because of you. Why did I even agree to this? I don't like hiking.
Hiking's fine, as long as you remember the water.
You're an idiot.
Name calling's gonna do nothing to help us.
Idiot! All right, I'll make you a deal. If you get us out of here, I'll stop calling you names.
Well, I highly doubt that. But sure, you got yourself a deal. Mind speed moving? Look, lights.
Is that a cabin?
Yeah, I think it is. I can taste the water from here.
I take it back, no deal. You really are an idiot. What is that awful smell?
It's gotta be a dead animal around here.
I think I'm gonna be sick. What is that? What is that?
Thank you.
all this, Michael. I've fallen in love with you. I didn't mean for it to happen, it just did. What about you, Michael? I know you've been married.
Twice.
Care to try for me? Daddy wants to meet you.
Why?
Because I told him about you. He's my father, Michael. He's very protective of his little girl. Meeting you would give him some comfort. He'd want to protect me, right? It's time, Michael. You can't hide from him forever. Fuck up, Bucko.
Michael Thornton?
You're on the list, Mr. Boy. So this is the bastard who wants to steal my daughter.
Hey, don't intimidate him. He's not like the others. He likes you.
So you are a businessman. I try. We know all about you, Michael Thornton.
You didn't think I would allow just anyone to sleep with my daughter.
You have made money and lost money. That is the way of business. Am I correct?
He is correct. But we are in the business of making money all the time.
That is why you are here. We want to include you.
Any man that wants to be with my daughter must give her the lifestyle she deserves.
And our business together will benefit your lifestyle greatly. You are a lucky man, Michael Thornton. A very lucky man.
Enjoy the rest of the evening, Michael. And be very good to my daughter. Your life depends on it.
Michael, he make joke.
You may leave now, Michael.
He's quick to judge. He's really quick to judge. But he likes you.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah, that's a good thing. Maybe he'll even get you involved in some of his business. Daddy's really good at business.
So he tells me. What's with those accents?
Sometimes it's better if people don't know you're Russian.
I like your laugh.
Well, that's good to know.
In fact, I like a lot about you.
You sound so shocked.
Oh, I am shocked, Sarah. I am shocked.
Drink.
It is important to us to have your loyalty, unquestioned loyalty.
You have a problem with that?
We have a new proposition for you, for all of us. It'll make you wealthy.
And the three of us wealthier.
But you are the unknown link.
We don't want you to be the weakest link, Michael.
Let me tell you a story about a guy who sell his soul to highest bidder.
That is you, Michael. You're selling your soul to us.
Goes into the champagne bucket.
Thank you.
it, Michael? You look like a man who just lost his puppy.
It's an easy job. You don't have a problem with that. It'll make you rich.
They own a jewelry store.
They're from the old country.
There's a large safe in the back of the store. They don't believe in banks.
We have Guyan inside. He'll show you safe. He'll already have the combination. He will unlock safe.
Listen to me carefully, Michael. I'm only going to say this once. Inside the safe, you will find cash and a large envelope. Do not look inside the envelope. Bring it back to us unopened.
You can keep the cash you find. How much cash? See, now we have interest. $3 million, maybe $5 million. Keep the cash. But the envelope?
The envelope you bring back to us. Now you're one of us, Michael.
Self-protection, huh? I understand that. We all need protection today. Am I right or am I right? Now this baby, this here is the terminator of all handguns. You can blow a hole so big in a man if you want to see Alaska, baby. And ain't nobody getting up after you use that cannon. 500, and I will throw in a box of pasta shells. Have I seen you before? You know you got the look of a killer? I don't mean that in a bad way. You got the look of a man who, if he's pushed just a little too far, yeah, you got the look of a stone-cold killer.
I think I made a big mistake.
Oh, baby, the only mistake you're going to make is walking out that door. There comes a time when everyone, and I mean everyone, wishes they had a gun. It's an easy job.
But they own a jewelry store. They don't believe in banks.
It'll make you rich.
We have Guyan inside. Be sure you say.
You can keep the cash you find. $3 million, maybe $5 million.
You're one of us.
So who died and left you king?
Nice,
huh? Better than nice. This is fantastic.
How can we afford it? Should I ask how?
I made a deal with Sarah's father.
I see. What kind of deal?
Relax, Jerry. No strings attached. The important thing is the company is once again helping.
Well, Mike, I don't want to rain on your parade, but there are good Russians. And there are bad Russians. Well, which one is he? Maybe I don't want to know. Just don't let him... Wow, this is a great view. Maybe I should learn to speak Russian so I can properly thank him. Them? Oh, it's a them now. What happened to her father?
He has partners, Jerry.
Mm-hmm. Russian partners? Don't get me wrong. Good Russians make good partners, but bad Russians... Bad Russians will leave us at the bottom of the harbor.
What are you worried about? You know how to swim.
Not with 100-pound weight cemented to my feet.
Then let's hope it doesn't come to
that. Oh, yeah, let's hope. Well, maybe. Just maybe. This will all be worth it. Hey, I'm gonna need a new wardrobe.
Yes, you are, Jerry. Yes, you are.
Jerry! What are you doing? It's your fiance.
My
fiance.
In what way is she trying to kill you, sir?
She's trying to bite me to death.
Sir, we have had an overload of prank calls tonight. Calling 911 as a joke is a crime. It is a felony.
I have two fingers and my big toe and razor to prove to you this is no damn joke.
What was that?
She's trying to get in.
Where are you now?
I'm locked in the bathroom.
Sir, listen to me. We have been inundated tonight with strange calls, but I will have a patrol car to you as soon as possible. What is your address?
33430 Rustic Hill Drive.
Do not open that door until the police arrive. Do you understand? Do you understand?
I'm not an idiot.
She's trying to kill my dog, really?
1 out of 4, this is dispatch. Do you copy?
Better answer. She'll never leave us alone.
10-4, dispatch. We copy. Loud and clear.
2-5, we have a domestic disturbance at 33430 Rustic Hill Road.
No, dispatch. Contact Ben. That's his patrol.
Don't think we have
it
been fine.
Ben
hasn't answered and has not called in.
He's probably sleeping and went off.
Again?
10-4, dispatch, we're on our way.
Please be advised. Victor's fiance is trying to bite him to death. He's locked himself in the bathroom.
Say again?
Victor's fiance is trying to bite him to death. He's locked himself in the bathroom. He says
he's bitten off
two of his fingers. And it's
10-4, dispatch. We'll muzzle her if needed. Over and out.
That must be one angry fiance.
Now, what would you do if your fiance, no less, bit off your toe?
You know what I'd do.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Let's not hurry this. If this guy can't take care of his woman...
Exactly.
I say we fire up one more. It'll give us better perspective of the overall situation when we get there.
Exactly.
Besides, he's locked himself in the bathroom.
In the old country, cut off your hands and feet. Leave you in the woods with the wolves. That way you'd still be alive when they devoured you. That's the old way.
Today, we have law to take care of a pound of flesh.
Most of the time.
Yes, most of the time.
But even in this country, we know how to make you pay.
You disappointed us, Michael. You invested our money without including us.
Your money?
Of course.
Whose money did you think it was?
You said keep the cash.
Yes, but it is not your cash.
Tovarich, we could not explain money, so you were our bank, Michael.
But make no mistake. It's our cash.
You truly didn't think the money was yours.
Sometimes in this country, you people have more balls than brains.
Which brings us back to our problem. We want our money.
There is no actual money. As you said, the money's invested.
You invested our money without including us.
You said keep the cash.
Don't play tough guy with us, Michael.
Maybe you think you are a tough guy, and we are dumb immigrants.
1 week. We want our money.
1 week, Michael. No more. Or you will wake up and find your big balls in your mouth.
People, and believe me, they don't look like you.
I want the cannon, and I'll take a suppressor.
We caught a silencer killer. Well, you're going balls deep, huh? Now, are you the hunter or the hunted?
Does it matter?
No, not really, but I wouldn't want you coming after me, especially with that monster. I don't use them, I just sell them.
What's wrong with this picture, Michael?
Maybe we should get moving.
Yeah. We better get moving.
We're at him for a jam problem.
We copy dispatch.
You're not going to believe this, but we're issuing a countywide emergency alert within the hour.
What gives?
Need to know basis. We'll get briefed after all cars return to headquarters.
What? We're being recalled?
That's a big 10-4. You can drop everything and return to HQ immediately. Do you copy?
10-4. Copy that.
Now what is up with that?
Beats the hell out of me. But the question is, do we still go up to Rust of King?
Well, if we gun it, if we really gun it, we're only about 10 minutes away.
And I, for one, want to see that killer fiance.
I want to see the ballless wonder.
I say we go for it.
I'm with you.
Well then, let's do it.
Thank you.
got Bucko.
Bigfoot, but they found him dead in the middle of the road with a tire iron sticking through his chest.
That's exactly what I'm hearing. They say the body measured 9 to 10 feet tall.
But authorities are not talking. They will neither confirm nor deny.
Obviously, they will be housed with Area 51 and all the little green aliens.
Oh, you are correct, sir.
I am indeed.
Any other local news of interest?
Local doctors were able to successfully reattach 2 fingers, a thumb, and a big toe to a man who must have thrown himself in front of a lawnmower.
You know, some guys will do anything just to get out of taking out the trash. Wow, a big toe. Amazing what science can do.
Amazing, amazing, amazing it is.
That's one lucky fellow.
He is indeed.
Now to warm up our night, here's some summer music.
You can imagine how skeptical people are right now. If this were to be released, is that the county water supply was contaminated with LSD.
Do you think I did this to myself?
Well, stranger things have happened to people under the influence of hallucinogens. But I digress. The only reason we agreed to this interview is that you maintain you have proof of what you say happened. Even you have to admit, your story is fanciful and quite difficult to believe.
Yes, I find it quite difficult to believe.
But you say you have proof. We need to see it, Michael.
When my fiance, she bit me many, many times. It was inevitable that her blood would mix with mine. I can feel changes.
But that's all well and good. But we need to see actual proof.
Oh, I'm going to show you proof. I'm going to show you all the proof you will ever need.